You all know the common force abilities like force push or force jump, but what about the ones that you don't really hear too much about, but are really cool and powerful? Starting off is the rare force ability of pyrokinesis. Pyrokinesis was a force power that allowed the force user to manipulate and generate fire by rubbing and heating up air molecules together. The ability seemed to have two major applications, the manipulation and the generation of fire. In generation, a force user typically generated fire from an already existing material, though a variant in which Jedi conjured flames from the sky was known and considered to overlap with alter environment. Yariel Poof exemplifies this by being famed for his ability to trigger fires by manipulating the molecules of combustible objects. Leia also demonstrated the ability to generate fire, as shown when she lit several candles through the force, commenting that Luke Skywalker had taught her how to do so. The second application is the manipulation. The force user was capable of directing and controlling an already existing flame with relative ease. In 52 BBY, Darth Sidious used the ability to kill Senator Pax Tem by coaxing a gentle flame from a gas-powered fireplace into a raging inferno. Although not directly seen doing so, a dream that Darth Vader had shortly before the Battle of Endor had Sidious creating a wall of fire separating Vader from his son, Luke Skywalker, after revealing his survival. Jedi Master Nal Vanari was so proficient in this ability that she was capable of controlling and redirecting an explosion, something that she did in order to save her friends, though at the cost of her life. The power is neutral in nature, with both Jedi and Sith showing equal ability in its use. Even other Force traditions such as the Night Sisters of Dathomir were known to use this ability. This is shown by the Dres Damo when she attempted to cast a spell of flame against attacking Sith, alluding to the existence of a Night Sister equivalent power pyrokinesis. Asajj Ventress used this power to make surrounding flames part and create a path she could pass without any injury, then let them reunite as she prepared to fight Anakin Skywalker. Moving on, we have the force power of Shatterpoint. Shatterpoints were a complex force phenomenon perceivable only by an unknown innate talent or immersed focus and concentration on the part of the force user. A notable user of Shatterpoint was the powerful Master Mace Windu. Shatterpoints were akin to fault lines, similar to different pathways of action. Adept force users were able to perceive these faults through the force and influence them. In relation to events, a single strike or action could cause events to transpire completely differently than they might have otherwise have. Often, Shatterpoints existed only for brief moments, as they could be affected by even the smallest actions. Shatterpoints could also be discovered in living beings. In Legends, Kate Skywalker was able to perceive Shatterpoints in Darth Talon, whom he had previously healed from mortal injury. By focusing through the force on where the healing had taken place, Skywalker was able to see where her old wounds were and reopen them. When applied to physical items, Shatterpoints worked much in the same manner. An individual will view an item through the force, noting where it came together and also noting weak points in its composition. By allowing the force to surge through them into a weak point, individuals would effectively shatter the object, causing it to break into multiple fragments. Because the force granted supernatural abilities to those who are adept in its use, materials thought to be near indestructible were easily destroyed. Next is the force power of Electric Judgment. Electric Judgment, also known as Emerald Lightning, was a force technique used by the Jedi to spray electric bolts of variable intensities from their hands and fingers. Despite being classified as a forbidden force power within the Jedi Order, a few Jedi such as Plo Koon practiced it. The Electric Judgment showed up as yellow, orange, or green force energy instead of blue or white, but otherwise it was very similar in both appearance and usage to the dark side force power known as Force Lightning. One common difference was that the Jedi's application came from a sense of determined justice, hence it being called Electric Judgment. During a mission to capture the criminal known as Dreed Pommel, Plo Koon confronted him at the suite in the city of Extra Metellos. Pommel had taken a young girl hostage and killed her entire family. During this encounter, Plo Koon let out a barrage of lightning at Pommel's head, and then a second burst of lightning that knocked him unconscious. He immediately reported this incident to the Jedi Council and stated that he did not feel any anger or fear as he let out the blast of lightning, but it was indeed calm and in control of his emotions. The council asked him to contemplate whether he felt it was wrong for him to have utilized his power during the mission and whether it should be used again. After much meditation, Plo Koon concluded that it would be wrong for him to ignore its power and that he should keep developing it into a useful technique. As requested by the council, he recorded his experiences with Force Lightning that he dubbed Electric Judgment on the Great Holocron. Coming up is the ability of Force Light. Force Light was the light side force power used by the Jedi. When used against a Darksider, Force Light would weaken the Darksider's connection to the Force. With the light side of the Force, a Jedi could either purge or contain dark side manifestations or nexus points, whether in places, spirits, or even living persons, though sometimes to detrimental effect. By channeling the Force into withering blasts of light side energy, the darkness can be then diminished or destroyed permanently. Force Light could also be used to sever the bond between a Sith Battle Lord and his or her followers. Jedi Master Yaddle was known to possess this ability, having learned it when studying Jedi Holocrons as head of the Librarian Assembly. Next up is the ability of becoming a Force Ghost. The Force Ghost was the soul and essence of a deceased Force sensitive who denied the will of the Force upon death, yet it was able to interact with the living. While most Jedi would lose their bodily envelope and become one with the Force upon their death, some had learned a technique allowing them to retain their own identity separate from the Force for a time. Those individuals would linger in the physical world in form of Force spirits, non-physical entities that inhabited most traits and abilities they had in life. A manifested spirit could wield Force powers, although not all of them. It also had the ability to travel instantaneously to any point in the galaxy by force of will. Some Sith Lords learned similar techniques, in which some cases allowed them to physically interact with their environment. Occasionally, their bodies would fade as Jedi would, though like Jedi, this was not a prerequisite for becoming a Force ghost. It wasn't uncommon for spirits of Sith Lords to remain bound to the living world through an object, location, or simply due to the force of their malice and hatred. Unlike the Jedi, however, the Sith found little peace in this form, instead existing for restless centuries, eventually driven insane by solitude, memories, or dark side inflicted madness.